This trailer is to help parents not be afraid to go into their kids' rooms. Not only is the addict afraid, if he's hiding drugs, it's either fear, it's either denial, or they're running from the cops. That can play on the parent's role or a loved one's role too. Fear can just eat you up if you let it. It's nothing but a liar. So what we're doing is we're showing parents and loved ones where people, addicts, kids, hide their drugs, whether they're hiding it for themselves, whether they're hiding it from for a friend. I'll start over here. This desk, I mean, there's, you know, we've got a Sharpie pen. These are going to become obsolete pretty soon, but just for an example, this Sharpie pen, you can order three of these online for $5. It's a great place to hide a pill. It's also, it is a pen, but it's a great place to hide a pill. Chewing gum. They sell things on the internet where you can hide pills in the Trident chewing gum. This little thing, great place to hide a pill. I mean, I don't even know what this is. I mean, it's a little magnet. As again, this is a mouse that is also a scale where they can weigh the drugs. I mean, pretty much on this desk are things that you would not think would be a place to hide any kind of pill or alcohol or whatever. We've had recovering addicts come through our trailer and say they would hide it in the disc, behind a disc. So this area over here, this is the not so obvious area. If you're missing spoons, if you see baggies, if you see Q-tips laying around, chances are they're melting the drug and using the cotton swabs to clean the drugs in the spoon, soaks it up, cleans it, and then they'll inject it, smoke it, whatever. The bags, typically on the street, when they buy drugs from a dealer, they'll put a pill or the weed or whatever, roll it up, and a great hiding place that you're not aware of is a baseball cap. Put it in the lid of a baseball cap. Put it in the tongue of your shoe. Does a parent go into a kid's room and look at their hats? Do they look at their old footballs that they've had on the shelf that they got at Little League? Do they look there? No. I'm going to be perfectly honest. Our son died of a drug overdose 3 years ago, and there were countless times when I knew Jay was using. Was I afraid to go into his room? Yes. What I've learned in the last 3 years? Yeah. Fear can eat you up. I'm just telling you, you don't want to be in my shoes. Don't be afraid. Get involved with your child. And it's not that I didn't get involved with my child, because I was a good mother and I was a good parent. I have two living girls that are living this nightmare. All of us living this nightmare. Don't be afraid. Our family made a choice. We made the choice to help other people not go through this horrible, horrible disease. And more stations and news people like you that can help families and addicts get through this, the better off. That stigma is horrible. Okay, these are the not so obvious things that just, they'll blow you away. I mean, this is a typical hairbrush. Let's talk about your son or your daughter's book bag, okay? Let's put a hairbrush, some Kleenex, tampons, deodorant. Let's put a bottle of water. Let's put a Coke. Let's put potato chips. Now, if you were going through that child's book bag, does anything look obvious? Doesn't look obvious to me. These are not potato chips. This is a great place to hide weed, a bottle of vodka, pills. You want a drink of water? guess what? It's not water. It's a great place to hide pills. Whatever. The Coca-Cola, another hiding place. That's not so obvious, is it? Right down to the hairbrush that unscrews at the bottom. The tampon, which is not a tampon. You can hide pills, you can hide weed, you can have liquor in there. The tissues. They're not tissues. Right down to the deodorant. So, you put all those things in the child's book bag, you have no reason to look. So what Not One More Alabama is trying to do, we're trying to tell you, go in your kid's room and look. I didn't. I thought it was Jay's face, and I left it alone. I'm not going to go back and say I didn't do everything for my son, because I did. These are ways for me, for our organization, to help other parents not go through this nightmare. All of this is a way to raise awareness. And I'm going to tell you one thing. I think God has sent me and our family to set an example. I don't think there's any question in my whole life that God has helped us get through this nightmare. And with organizations like Not One More Alabama, with support from TV stations, with support from loved ones, we can help other people. And it's not just the people, it's a disease. We can help the addicts. That's what it's all about. If you can go into church, if you can go into the school, if you can be on a PTA meeting and look at your friend that's next to you and say, how are you doing? And she looked at you and said, I'm not doing really well. My son, my daughter, I think they're using drugs. Well, then we're doing our job, because the more that we do to raise awareness, the better off everybody is. The addict, the families of the addicts, everybody. Okay. Sorry. Not One More Alabama has an incredible website. We have a website that provides tools for parents that don't know what to do or who to call. We have books that you can look at, but we also have a volunteer part on our page, and we have the trailer on our page. And if you go to Not One More Alabama's website and look up the trailer, you can request a visit from the trailer. We have four volunteers. Well, no, I shouldn't say that. We have tons of volunteers that drive. We have tons of volunteers that'll help take you through the trailer. But we are happy to come visit your school, come visit your business, come visit any type of institution. But all you have to do is pick up the phone and call Not One More Alabama, or just look at our website.
Any kind of message you want to get out to parents that might suspect?
The main message that I would like to convey to parents, to loved ones, is don't be afraid. You can either choose to be afraid, or you can choose to help. My family has chosen to help. Like I said in the beginning, it's addiction affects the addict, it affects the family, and it affects the friends. When you minus out fear and you minus out denial and you look to God for help and support from your friends and your family, you can pretty much get through a lot of nightmares.